A Midsummer Night's Dream by William Shakespeare. Our story starts off in the city of Athens with our four lovers. The problem with these four lovers is...
I love Lysander.
I love Hermia.
I also love Hermia.
I love your mom.
What? And I love Demetrius, who doesn't seem to know I exist.
So you can see where the problems start. So Hermia and Lysander hatch a plan.
Ta-da!
Okay, here's our plan, Stan.
But my name's not Stan!
I know, it's just, never mind, you wouldn't understand.
Okay.
Anyways, we're going to run away and get married, like Britney Spears in Vegas. Tomorrow night, we are going to run away and meet in the woods outside of Athens and finally be away from this place.
The only problem was that someone was listening to them talk.
So, they're going to run away together? Maybe if I tell Demetrius, he'll fall in love with me and finally see that Hermia isn't that perfect.
The next night in the woods, the fairy queen Titanic...
Titania!
Oops. The fairy king Oberon and a fairy named Puck get into a fight over an Indian boy. So, to get back at his wife, Oberon asks Puck to find Cupid's love flower to put some of it onto Titania's eyes at night, so when she awakes, she'll fall in love with the very first thing she sees. So to embarrass her, Puck and Oberon find Bottom, an actor in the woods. Then decide to turn his head into a...
Titania!
Oh, come here, cutie! I just want to kiss you and look at those big sexy ears! Wah, wah, wah!
Oh my, she's crazy. But I love this. What?
At another part of the forest, the four lovers get into a fight because of Puck's mistakes. Puck puts the same flower potion on Lysander and Demetrius' eyes. But see, the problem is that he was only told to put it on Demetrius' eyes in hopes he'd see Helena no longer be in love with Hermia. But of course, nothing goes as planned, and both the boys wake up and see one another. So in a turn of fate, both boys are now madly in love with each other. Wait, that's not right. In a turn of fate, both boys are now madly in love with Helena. That's more like it.
Lysander, what is going on? You're supposed to be in love with me, not her. A few hours ago you wanted to marry me. Now you're all over her?
Yep, that's true. But I see things in a new light. She's got this look in her face, and it's got a hold on me, like those glasses, and...
Oh, okay, just stop!
No, Lysander, you can have Hermia. Helena's all mine, so back off.
What is this, some crazy dream? Please wake me up. Why do both you boys want Helena? I am so mad, I'm gonna kill you with something sandpapery and hard.
Let me borrow that top.
Whoa. You guys are all going crazy. You must be playing a trick. How could they want me? I'm leaving before this gets any worse.
So, as you can see, thanks to Puck, all goes to hell. So, by Oberon's order, Puck must fix what he's screwed up. For better! So, Lysander awakes and he is back in love with Hermia. Puck left Demetrius in love with Helena so that no one of the four would be left out. So, after the four lovers are reunited, they go back to Athens for the wedding of King Theseus to Queen Hippo. But before that...
So, Hermia, you down to get hitched, boo?
Ooh, yeah.
Alright then, let's go.
So anyway, since Lysander and Hermia are in love and getting married, how about we do that?
You mean, get hitched? Us?
Yeah, why not?
What? Wow, I thought you'd never ask. No.
What?
You're too much of an emo boy, and...
I need a hero! I'm holding up a hero to...
Haha, just messing with you. Let's get married.
So, all the lovers gather for the party after the king's wedding. Once all the people go off to bed, the fairies come out and bless the house with magic sprinkles and beautiful butterflies.
Yay!
And everyone lives pretty much happily ever after. Oh, and by the way, Titania and Oberon work out their little problem over the Indian boy, and Titania is no longer in love with Bottom. And thanks to Puck, Bottom is no longer half-assed.
Be-boom!
And all is well. The end, for now.
Wow.